In this video, we're going to explain exactly when and how to use de, della, del, and al.
Sí, este tema suena un poco confuso, pero realmente vas a ver que es muy sencillo.
And we're going to teach you some more advanced phrases with de to help you sound more native in your day-to-day conversation.
Empezamos.
Like most prepositions in Spanish, de is a bit of a tricky one, because it has many different translations in English, depending on the context. For example, sometimes it can translate to from.
Soy de la Ciudad de México.
I'm from Mexico City.
O, ¿de dónde vienes?
Where are you from?
Pero también se puede traducir a of. Por ejemplo, quiero un vaso de agua.
I want a glass of water.
O, vamos al depa de Ana.
Let's go to Ana's apartment. And yeah, in that last example, it actually works like an apostrophe S.
Y hasta se puede traducir a about. Estamos hablando de la película.
We're talking about the movie. And we'll run you through some idiomatic uses a little later. But anyway, when exactly do we use del?
Pues básicamente usamos del cuando la palabra después de es el artículo masculino el.
Yeah, it's important to remember that all nouns in Spanish have a gender. So the translates to el if the noun is masculine, and la if the noun is feminine. So, if the article el comes after a de, the two kind of fuse together to create del.
Por ejemplo, no diríamos, los británicos siempre hablan de el clima. Tienes que decir, los británicos siempre hablan del clima.
Which means the Brits always talk about the weather. Which isn't true, by the way.
Sí, es cierto. Pero bueno, también diríamos, quiero una copa del vino que trajiste.
Which means, I want a glass of the wine you brought. But there is an exception.
Siempre.
Yeah, if the el is part of a name or title of something, then in written Spanish, you don't contract the de and el.
Por ejemplo, yo soy de El Paso.
I'm from El Paso.
O, la gente de El Triunfo es muy amable.
The people in El Triunfo are really friendly.
Sí, pero cuando estamos hablando, muchas veces usamos del en este contexto también. Por ejemplo, podrías decir, soy del Paso.
Yeah, it's just a bit easier on the old tongue. Ah, and it's super important to note that the de-la combination never contracts. So if you have a de followed by a la, you don't need to do anything.
¿Y qué es al?
Well, actually, it follows pretty much the same logic as del. So whenever you have an a directly followed by the article el, you're going to have to fuse or contract the two to form al. So in Spanish, you can't say, me gusta ir a el cine. No, you have to say, me gusta ir al cine.
¿Y cómo se usa?
Well, al normally translates to the. A means to and el means the. And usually you use it to talk about movement from one place to another. For example,
vamos al banco.
Let's go to the bank.
Vamos a ir al puerto este fin de semana.
We're going to the port this weekend.
Lanzó la pelota al niño.
He threw the ball to the boy.
Y hay otro uso muy útil de al, ¿verdad?
Yeah, so al plus infinitive, so the simple unconjugated verb, is really going to improve your spoken Spanish. And it basically translates to when plus subject plus verb, or on plus verb in ing form. Let's take a look at a couple of examples.
Al llegar a la playa, fui directo al mar.
On arriving, or when I arrived at the beach, I went straight to the sea.
Al ver que habían invitado a mi ex, me escondí en el baño.
On seeing, or when I saw that they'd invited my ex, I hid in the bathroom.
¿Es verdad?
Of course not. I think it's time for some more advanced phrases with de, right? So, as promised, there are also some super useful idiomatic phrases with de.
Sí, si usas estas frases vas a sonar mucho más local.
Yeah, in Spanish, you can actually use de to connect two nouns, to kind of link them together. So, for example, ropa de trabajo means work clothes.
O salida de emergencia significa emergency exit. Y una condel es la pila del bautismo.
Which means baptism or font. And I strongly recommend that you learn these phrases in chunks, i.e. as entire phrases, because they're obviously quite different from the English.
Y también es muy común usar de cuando queremos enfatizar que alguien hizo algo muy rápido.
Yes, so de golpe translates to something like suddenly. For example, you could say,
la puerta se abrió de golpe.
The door opened suddenly.
La manzana se cayó del árbol de golpe.
All of a sudden, the apple fell from the tree.
Y si quieres decir algo como in one sitting, se puede decir de una sentada. Por ejemplo, Brenda se comió el pastel de una sentada.
Brenda ate the whole cake in one sitting.
Llegó la hora de nuestra prueba final.
But before we get into the test, guys, if you found this video useful, please drop us a like or a comment down below. We'd really appreciate it.
Y ahora sí, vamos a completar nuestras siguientes frases con de la, del y al. ¿Listos? Hay que hablar, ting, problema con los vecinos.
We need to speak about the problem with the neighbors. This time the answer is del, because you've got de plus el. Remember that problema is a masculine noun, despite the fact that it ends in a.
Vamos, ting, supermercado mañana.
Let's go to the supermarket tomorrow. And here you're going to need to use al, because you're translating to the, or a el.
Estos gatos son ting vecina.
Those are the neighbor's cats. And the answer is de la, because we're talking about a female neighbor.
Dejé de fumar ting golpe.
I quit smoking cold turkey. And yep, the answer is de, as we're using the expression de golpe.
Y bueno, es todo por hoy. Mil gracias por vernos.
Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. And if you want to level up your Spanish even further, then definitely check out our video on what to say and what not to say in restaurants in Spanish-speaking countries.
Sí, no se lo pueden perder.
See you there.